You see, the night time is a time that each and every one of us saves for those things that we truly love. Let me give you an example. A person that has a day job, goes to work in the morning, tired by the end of the day, comes home, sits down, does the errands, finally it's the night time. This is the time in which this individual will sit around doing that thing that he really loves. If it happens to be a TV show, that will be the time. And even television stations know that the best time to offer the best entertainment is that time right before your sleep, the time which we can call pretty much nighttime or beyond that as well, right? So this is the time in which we do things we love. When it comes to romance, people are romantic with their special others at nighttime as well. When it comes to many other things that are beloved to individuals, nighttime is the time for that. Now, Allah wants you to take from this night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet ﷺ also to take from this night. And he says that, give me a portion of this night. قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. The night time that you so love, the night time that you've saved for the most special moments of your life, take that special moment, take that moment of the day which is saved for those special moments, and give me a portion of that, O my slave. قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. Half of it, or do a little bit less than half, or more than the half, but make sure you're reciting the Quran ترتيلا beautifully, with melody, in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had revealed this Quran. You see, my dear brothers and sisters, the night time is that time in which you can connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ways that you can never connect other than nighttime. How so? We know that it is during the night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends in a way that is befitting to His majesty. And He says to His slaves that, is there someone who's asking so I may grant? Is there someone who's calling so I may also answer that call? So this is your opportunity to make a connection with Allah Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. Also, during the nighttime, you're far away from what? You're far away from all the occupations of life and all the hustle and bustle of life and the noise that takes place on streets and all of these things. And Allah says, because of that, in the Quran, Inna nashi'ata al-layli hiya ashaddu wat'an wa aqwa muqila. It is the nighttime when a person wakes up that he's able to comprehend better, and it is that time that a person can absorb the meanings of the Quran as well better. So take from this night and read the Quran. Take from this night a portion and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in qiyam. If you do so, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow you to enter Jannah. How so? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that, O people, ya ayyuhan nas, afshu salam, say salam to the people, wasilu al-arham, and also enjoin the ties of kin as well, wa at'imu al-ta'am, and feed the people as well, وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٍ, and pray at night times while people happen to be sleeping as well. Night time, everybody happens to be sleeping. So the Prophet ﷺ is saying, you be that individual, if you truly desire Jannah, you be that individual who wakes up at night time for even a moment. It doesn't have to be very long. You see, Qiyamul Layl can just be a few minutes, and that will still be considered Qiyamul Layl. That will still be considered night prayer. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he continued and he said, تَدْخُلُوا جَنَّةَ رَبِّكُمْ بِالسَّلَامِ أَوْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِالسَّلَامِ. You will enter the Jannah of your Lord by peace and through peace. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter us into His Jannah with peace. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send peace and blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who had taught us this piece of beautiful advice. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.